All right, so we're still picking loadouts and everything. Plus, we get our 3-minute delay before we can stream, so it'll be just a few more minutes. All right, and here comes our spectator delay. So once that's done, we should be live in the round. All right, 45 seconds, we're almost there. right, guys, so we are rolling. I'm not going to be giving a bunch of commentary on this game because honestly I don't know. But I will be happy to answer questions in chat if I can.
So, when you got dressed this morning, was this the look you were going for?
Minions have spawned.
Why are you so boring?
Let's go.
Weakling.
Ah, I got it.
I am out of patience. I've already figured you out.
A lady never dirties her hands.
to get you.
Thank you.
Your attempts are feeble. The trick is to be clever and quick. So predictable.
Twilight Fair!
of good manners is patience.
Huh!
not a good sign.
No, it just didn't open automatically because your mouse was over here or something. Yeah.
All right, there we go.
So, we're red team, so I'm going to switch. Subiaco, red team this game, whatever opponent we are, I don't remember. Blue team.
Oh, it's,
Subiaco's all going top path.
30 seconds
to do something.
Until minions spawn.
We're all in the bush. While the blue team is doing 5-man invade protection. They placed a ward down on Subiaco's blue buff.
We're playing Jonesboro.
Jonesboro, okay, that's blue team. Subiaco's bot lane, support is back, mid lane, out to...
Do you want to smell it?
Go help.
Not for you!
They're just kind of hanging.
Yeah, Jonesboro is going for the leash on red buff, and it's where the bot lane helps the jungle take it.
Come on!
Jungle doesn't do so much trying to take red buff.
Yeah.
And then they leave, the jungle can get the red buff secure, and they can go... And it looks like Jonesboro stole it probably from him. He really likes it. So he's going with one of his second or third favorites, Renekton the Crocodile.
Sword Legs Lady, love it.
Yep.
That was probably really loud.
Yeah, it's fine. They don't care. We got a number of viewers. I don't know.
I have one on Twitch.
Yeah.
Running will make no difference.
All right, so Subiaco lost the first round.
Yep, they won. They lost the first game. Looks like we're losing these trades, but we do get to have the minion wave top lane freeze in front of our turret, which is nice because they can't contest that, so they just basically get free AXP. But with, I think, Karma or Camille is her name, she likes to dive in top lane anyways. Get a couple hits off on him. But Renekton also likes to dive. They're both dive champions. So Lulu's taking some damage. Jinx just trying to get some experience.
Yeah, I saw one of them pop to level up.
Yeah. Looks like they have a gank happening. Mid lane and Aurelia, our mid laner, is about to go down. Graves just trying to help out and take out their new will jungle.
You won't avoid the consequences of your actions.
It looks like the tables have turned top lane and Renekton has now pushed up his wizard minion wave. There. New will and the support is done in the jungle. Probably waiting out drag. Oh, they've
so
separated the guy. With Birdman going back down. Zaya looking to poke over there on the Jinx. Graves comes down to help, stunning, slowing, hoping for things to maybe get some damage off on him. and they push him back down, back to turret, try to clear up that wave of minions. And like Zed being
so you have to blow up the turrets before you can go to the main base, right?
Yeah. I mean, you can go to the main base, but you're not gonna get anything out of it, because the turrets will shoot you and do several hundred points of damage.
So what does destroying the other turrets do? Lower their damage output?
It means your minions can go up there and take the shots for you, so you can do damage.
Oh, okay, so technically you could skip all of that and just go attack the main base, but you probably wouldn't.
But if you look here, the main base has two turrets directly in front of it.
Yeah.
And so they're just gonna wall up you. Looks like Zed pushed up a little bit hard on Lane. And did not get punished that much. Lifesteal off. Trying to even out the playing field top. Waiting for his cooldowns to come back. Both waiting to reach their level 6 to do something big, maybe. Not there yet, though. Look. Looks like he was hungry for a kill there. Wasn't able to get it, though. Look. This might be it, though. Both of them are low on health. Oh, and she gets level 6 first and just kills with it. Because at level 6, they get their ultimate move. Because that box...
And that's leveling up during the round, right?
Yeah, they level up during, like, not the account level, but their character.
My side and the wrong side.
And Renekton comes back with a quick teleport, maybe to hoping to push that Kendo.
And they're going for the buff here, right?
Yeah, they're going for the Dragon Ball. Jonesboro is. And that's Inferno, so it gives them bonus damage. Each different kind of dragon does a different buff. And if... team gets 4 dragons, they can summon a dragon and get a dragon soul if they kill it, which is super powerful. And the dragon buffs are permanent, they last the whole game.
Oh, okay, so they don't wear out.
No, like, unlike the red and blue buffs, which have a cooldown of like 60 second duration, I think, or 45, something like that. And looking for some stun. She has this shield and she gets away with her grappling hooks. Aurelia just playing defensively mid lane. Both low HP top lane. It looks like her mill's been consistently buying potions or she's just been saving them.
Because she drank quite a bit there.
Look, that's what the glowing green thing is. She used a potion to heal. Or something to heal. There are some runes that just give you biscuits.
I love biscuits.
Yeah.
They're good. Now I'm hungry. Thanks.
I'm sorry. They put honey or cinnamon rolls in the game for food. Your character gets them at a certain time and they heal. I would feel better. Cinnamon roll too.
Dude, that's no cinnamon roll, man. No. Thanks. Yeesh. Lunch was good today, though.
Yeah. Let's chat real quick. See who's building what. Oh wait. Yeah. Nope.
I don't know what the commands are.
It's something. It doesn't matter. And Jinx, yeah, no one's got a mythic yet. They're all working on it. Looks like one of our carries, Jinx, was slain bot lane, but mid came down and helped and cleaned it up. Get a little bit of bonus experience. I think that was a wandering head. Yes, it was a wandering head. So earlier, just followed the dumb girl Finland that left the and Renekton is able to stop a ganking vault, which is good. Very impactful. Sure. Renekton uses all, and now it's over. Deal with
patience is what separates good hunters from.
Yeah, there's a lot of minions there though.
Yeah. The thing is, if you push your minions up to the turret, but they're there, the enemy is there under their turret, you can't really fight the enemy because the turret will auto lock onto you instead of the minions, and you'll take tower shots. And so you're getting damage by the enemy and the turret at the same time. With some characters, like Carmille, can use a tower dive dash, which grants her a temporary shield, which can take a shot for her.
Or at least one shot.
Yeah, at least one. Sometimes two if she builds it right. Looking for a shot there, but misses. Actually looking for a point. I'm going with that damage. The Volibear stealing jungle thunder. He's doing a little bit slow in support. Renekton is going to go down. Yep. Warding drag. Looks like Jonesboro is gonna try and go for drag, but as quickly as possible. Subi is looking to kill him. And it looks like they're not gonna do that, and they're instead just gonna look to do a team fight. Lulu fires it out of there. Zed jumps over the wall. Looks like Zed's by himself and he's gonna take a lot of damage, maybe. Everyone's taking a fair bit of damage here on the Jonesboro side. The whole team except for their top lane went down there. It is usual.
The only standard that matters.
And it looks like Subi gets to take this drag now. Oh, no. Jonesboro is looking for the steal after they saw Subi go in.
So, what happens there?
Whoever kills it gets a buff. It looks like Subi took it.
Okay. So, you could just walk in
and steal it.
Do that last hit.
Mm-hmm.
And that's for your whole team.
Yeah.
Wow, that's kind of sucky.
Mm-hmm.
It should be based on who did the most damage.
But then you can't really counterplay a team going to drag. It's like if they get it halfway down, who gets it?
Well, I guess that's true, but still. Seems a little...
Yeah.
Iffy.
In most teams, whenever they see an opponent going there, they either rush it to get it dead as quickly as possible, or they all stop fighting drag and then do a team fight.
Yeah. Or you could just hide in the bush.
Yeah.
And go in and get the last hit.
Mm-hmm. That's what a couple of characters do, like Lux. Yeah. But Lux has other abilities that make her useful during the fight. She has like a shield. But her main thing for damage is her ultimate, which is a giant laser.
Well, I think we just lost a turret.
We already lost the top, but mid.
I think that
was. Yeah, it was depending on who won that little
close.
Thing. It's close. But since they won that little engagement with Zed, it gets to live for another day. Aurelia looking to back to heal because they lost half their health. Zed is already. Oh, looks like top came down to punish them for it, though.
Ooh,
yep. Graves up in the enemy vision. Warding both bushes down there. Trojans looking to come down to go help bot lane, but Jonesboro's bot lane disengages. Is hovering, waiting for a bit. My support love to destroy some vision. Couldn't find any of mid lane diving in, hoping to get damage, but wasn't able to do anything on the pro side. Little engagement bot lane.
That's a little thing that they're out there that are chattering.
Yeah, it's one of Jinx's moves, who is Ben is playing our carry bot lane. She can throw like little spike round caps.
The test of good manners is patience. So predictable.
Like, Subiaco is losing top lane by a fair margin. Yeah. Speeding it a little bit. And Graves looking to high top lane from the Bull Bear, but unable to do so. The Bull Bear uses his ult for one shot. Or not one shot. To finish him off. Secure. It's like jungle and Jonesboro's top lane is going to finish off that second line turret.
Top lane. The future favors the versatile.
Aurelia looking to come up for support to maybe help defend this one. With Lulu and Renekton coming to join her.
So what's the significance of that little mini base there?
So, if Jonesboro were to destroy that little red crystal, it would summon super minions for Jonesboro, which have a large amount of health and do a fair bit of damage to towers. And that's what, that's the main thing you use when going to attack the main base here.
Yeah.
Because they will not, if you get two inhibitors, the turrets are basically locked forever after that point. Because they just have so much health. They were able to get that kill on the Zed there. Zed is a mean carry if he gets banned. Carmille is manageable. You're able to stun her or something. It is scary for Renekton top lane. He's taken zero turrets. Jinx able to get a few quick shots off him before having to leave. When Carmille comes bot lane, who is now wandering because she's basically taken all the important turrets top lane. Landing phase is over for her. And it's Renekton just looking to catch up top, and Zed is going up there to stop Renekton. Will he get there in time? No, looks like he won't. But he will be able to punish Renekton. Gets the kill.
Alright, they're going after another dragon.
Yep, I'm getting the first dragon. Pieces. Okay. Subi has the water dragon, which gives him a slight health regen, but Jonesboro now has Inferno, which gives him slight damage, or had has gotten death. Inferno, a slight damage increase, and they're about to get the Earth Dragon for some defense, which there should be. Top lane. Zed looking to go in here. Minions pushing in hard from Jonesboro on this turret. Maybe looking for something from somebody eventually. I don't know. Renekton was able to fend off that Zed though. Zed looking to punish Renekton. Being unable to do so. Looks like looking to grab the scuttle right before it disappears from Jonesboro, which is like a super minion, but it has more health, does more damage, more reckless. It has lots of health, and it can. It waits right outside of turret firing range, and it goes and does massive damage to a turret. For at the cost of its own health. And if you're smart, you can get two turrets for the price of one Rift Scuttle. like both bot lane and support to come up here to feed on Renekton. Renekton looking to not be food, tries to escape, and Volibear is also up there, hoping to get an ambush set up with Graves and Aurelia. Graves looking awesome, not wanting to die. Still diving. And it looks like they get the Aurelia too. But Jinx and Lulu still trying to get that first turret bot lane. And they get the kill on Zaya. Maybe be able to push turret. Yep, and that means they're going to destroy Inhibitor with that Rift Scuttle. Or Rift Herald. No, I say Scuttle. Scuttle's the little guys in the river. Yeah, they are going to take that turret, and then Inhibitor is going to be basically gone. Yep.
Oh!
It was massive damage.
That was a huge hit.
Yeah. That's what Rift Herald's for, but it cost him his own HP. He can't do it forever.
Is that a Rift Herald character, or is that one of the minions?
No, he's just a monster. But if you kill him, you can summon him.
Oh. You don't take that one too.
Play as him. And it looks like they were able to get the top inhibitor as well, killing Renekton. But it's just been a source of constant food for Jonesboro this game. Looks like they almost get Lulu.
They've already gotten one turret out.
Zed gets a Lulu.
Yeah, that one's busted.
Oh, crazy. I didn't see that. Subiaco only has two turrets left and one inhibitor, and there is a large wave of minions just smacking that final base turret left before they move on to their grand prize.
Oh,
Renekton using
man.
His ult there, trying to push every the enemy Jonesboro team out. It just looks down because there are five people there.
That's it.
Yep. And that's game.
That's a game.
Victory for Jonesboro, not for Subiaco.
All right, guys. That's it for us. Thanks for coming out. We hope to see you.